let's take an in-depth look at Dominator from Audio Assault. All right, here we are with Dominator from Audio Assault. Right now we have this on a mono track, but you can also instantiate this on a stereo track as well. That really comes into play for, you know, just people who like to use a stereo track, or for one of the effects here called the doubler, one of our stomps here. It doesn't really do much on a mono track, but you can throw this on a stereo track and you'll get a bit of a doubling effect. So let's go ahead and go through Dominator here. We'll start up here with the gate. So the gate can help cut off, you know, if you have too long of a sustaining sound. Maybe whenever you're doing palm mutes, if you want that really djenty sound, you can really up your gate and it will cut off sound after it goes below the threshold. You can also raise your gate if you're getting too much amp noise, too much sustain, so on and so forth. That's how a gate works. Up here, again, across the top, we have stomp, amp, and cabinet. We'll come back to those in just a minute. And then we have our output section right here. So that will boost the overall output of the entire chain here. So if you have settings that maybe the gain is really low, maybe your bass or mid or treble is very low, so on and so forth, you can compensate with your output section up here. Heading over to the stomps, you can see we have five different slots where we can put a bunch of different included stomp effects. Choose whichever ones you want. And then, of course, you can move them around, turn them on and off, just like any other stomp effect. Another thing you can do is you might come in here and bypass the amp and bypass your cabinet, and then you can use the stomps as an effect on a different audio track or for a different guitar amp simulator. Pretty cool. Again, move them around, turn them on and off. Lots of stomps included here. You also have the option to throw those through the effects loop instead. Here on the main amp page, the Dominator, as I mentioned, you can bypass the amplifier. We have two channels, channel A and channel B. Turn off channel B for now. Channel A is an overall lower gain channel. You can get some cleaner sounds, some overdriven sounds through channel A. So we have gain, bass, mid, and treble. You can also double click and just type in a value on any of these parameters if you want. Now don't let channel A fool you. You can actually get some rather high gain sounds out of channel A, especially if you combine that with some of your stomps here. You can actually get some really creamy overdriven solo tones and lead tones by using, say, a screamer, maybe a chorus, and maybe something like a delay or even a reverb. Then we have our monster channel B. Now this channel here sounds fantastic from the get-go. Almost any setting you choose will be a modern metal sound that, again, it just sounds amazing. You can really up the gain and get a lot of saturation, although diming it out, it's going to be way too much. You might want to really experiment with lower gain settings, especially if you're double tracking your guitars. You're not going to need that much gain for, you know, two guitars or three guitars, because you'll end up really making your mix a bit more muddy overall. But you can get a lot of gain out of this amp, even at lower settings, around 3, 4, 5, and 6. You can get some really great metal tones out of this amp. And one of the reasons I really like Dominator is it's not afflicted with that really hairy sort of fizzy top end that a lot of amp simulators have. Now you might get a good tone, but whenever you really listen to it and try to fit it in the mix, you notice just this high-end fizz poking out everywhere that's almost impossible to control. And you might even try to use a high pass, but then you end up killing your tone. Dominator is not afflicted with that. It's a great algorithm. It sounds fantastic, even just on the default preset. So then, of course, we have our gain, our bass, our mid, our treble, and presence, just all basic controls. Again, double click, and you can just type in a value if you want. Channel B is just a monster metal channel. We also have presets. This ships with several presets here. You can also, of course, save and load your own presets that you create. Moving on from there, we have our cabinet section. Our cabinet section is very, very important, because your cabinet is going to make a huge difference to your overall sound. First, we can double click on the grill here to hide that, just in case you want to see the actual speakers. Double click again to bring it back. Down here on cabinet, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 different cabinets to choose from. We have our British 4x12, a nice classic cabinet for a great sound. We have our American 2x12. We have a Japanese 2x12. And we have a German 4x12, which is probably one of my favorite. All of these are great. From there, we also have several microphones to choose from. Our Dynamic 57, which of course is based on the SM57, which is just tuned sort of just right for capturing things like guitar, because it sort of rolls off that low end so it doesn't get too boomy. Great overall microphone for guitar. Then we have a condenser microphone. A condenser is going to capture a much larger range of tone. So you may need to come in here and sort of compensate, especially on your low end, because it can get a little bit boomy there. But we also have a high pass and low pass, which we'll get to in a minute. From there, we have a ribbon microphone, which is sort of like our condenser in that it's going to capture a larger range of frequencies. So again, you might have to compensate a bit on the low end just so it doesn't get too boomy, because you really want your bass and your kick drum to fill out that lower end without things getting too muddy. If you have too much going on in the low end, you can actually make your mix sound smaller overall. And then we have a dynamic 421, which is a larger diaphragm dynamic microphone. Okay, so that's all of our microphones. Another thing we can do is, of course, move the microphone around to any position that you want and get a bunch of different, very usable tones. Just move it around wherever you want, drop it, and you're good to go. From there, we also have the ability to turn the cab off, which we've already seen. But we also have a distance control for our microphone and high pass and low pass. So the distance will give you more of that airy sound, more of that room tone, just bringing the microphone away from the cabinet. Just dial that in to taste. You can really get a lot of that room tone if you want to go really high with it. Very small settings in this make a pretty big difference. Then we have our high pass and our low pass. In case you don't know what that is, here is a high pass. Let me just turn this on. This is a high pass. A high pass lets the highs pass. So the more I pull out, the more of that low end I can pull out from the guitar. You may want to pull out up to 100, maybe up to 150. It really sort of depends. And it may not even be up to 100. You may just want to pull off somewhere around 40, 50, 60, something like that. And it can help control that really low end sound of your guitar and just free up a bit more space in that low end for other instruments. A low pass is going to do the opposite, in which it's going to pull out the top end. So if it's just too harsh on the top end, a little too fizzy perhaps, which even though Dominator doesn't really get fizzy, if it's just a bit too harsh and you like the overall tone, you can just pull out some of that top end there and get the tone that you want. So that is what these controls do here, our high pass and our low pass. But that's not all that Dominator can do. We can come down here to our cabinet, and you can see we have IR cabinet. So we can use impulse responses instead of these cabinets right here. Now this ships with several impulse responses. It doesn't come with these here. I actually pulled those in, which I'll show you here in a minute. But it comes with several impulse responses that you can use. And if you choose an impulse response, then you have your impulse response volume knob here. So if the impulse response is a little too quiet, you can up that right here. Of course, we don't have the distance control because impulse responses are recorded at certain distances. But we still have our high pass and our low pass. Now, if you're like me and you already have an expansive collection of impulse responses, I can't come in here, which I have the entire Redwire's impulse response big box bundle. I can't just come in here and grab an impulse response and then drag and drop it in. So if I want to drop it in here, can't do that. What you can do, though, is, of course, bypass your cabinet and then use whatever impulse response loader that you like. So I would probably use my Redwire's Mix IR2 and load my impulse response right up in here and use this for my guitar cabinet and just have this one here bypassed. Okay? But you don't have to do that. There is a sort of a workaround to get whatever impulse response is in to Dominator that you want. So just click this folder icon. Now, this folder icon doesn't give us a load option, so we can't just choose something and load it. Now, I could navigate to this folder, but it wouldn't do me any good because I can't load anything from it. But what you can do is just head over to wherever your impulse responses are, choose the one that you want, and then drag it over to the folder for Dominator, where Dominator holds its impulse responses. Now, don't move it from whatever folder it's in, but copy it over, because you'll probably want to keep your impulse responses together. So we'll just copy this one over. This is the Engel Pro with the V30s. There we go. You can do this in real time, by the way. We don't have to close the plugin. Come back over here, and now we'll have our Engel Pro right there and ready to use right here in Dominator. So that is Dominator from Audio Assault, a really amazing sounding plugin for that modern metal tone. Loaded with features from our gate to all of our stomps that we can choose from and move around however you want to, of course, the amazing amplifier with our two different channels, and of course the cabinet section, which the cabinets already sound great. But if you don't like the cabinets or you just want something a little different, you can of course load your impulse responses here as well, and of course move that microphone around wherever you want, distance, high pass, low pass, and of course, save and load your very own presets right here in Dominator. From new American metal to groove metal to even black metal, death metal, or djent metal. You can do all of that with Dominator, and again, sounds absolutely amazing. We'll be right back. that was an in-depth look at Dominator from Audio Assault.